Earlier in the day he spoke out about his latest directorial debut, branding it an angry movie for an angry country his own. But George Clooney was all charm as he arrived at the premiere of Suburb Icon with his stunning wife of 3 years Amal, 39, on Saturday. The Hollywood actor, 53, kicked off the annual 74th Venice Film Festival in style, arriving to the star-studded event by speedboat. Dressed in an impeccably tailored black suit, he embellished his crisp white shirt with a black bow tie, his silver hair swept into a side parting. He was only upstaged by a glamorous Amal, who slipped her curves into an elegant lilac gown, boasting a corset-style neckline. The human rights lawyer, 39, accentuated her slender midriff in the cinched-in piece, which flowed out into a floor-scheming full skirt. Wearing her raven bob into a perfectly blow-dried side parting, Amal sported bold brows and lashings of mascara, completing her look with statement beaded earrings and a bold red lip. Their appearance comes after they welcomed twins Elle and Alexander on June 6, and the family have been splitting their time between their Berkshire mansion and Lake Como. Speaking at the photo call back in Venice, Italy earlier in the day, George said his latest directorial effort, Suburb Icon, is an angry movie for an angry country, his own. It's a twisted tale of darkness at the heart of the American dream. A lot of us are angry, angry at ourselves, angry at the way that the country is going, angry at the way the world is going, Clooney told reporters Saturday in Venice, Italy, where Suburb Icon is competing for the festival's Golden Lion Prize. It's probably the angriest I have ever seen the country, and I lived through the Watergate period of time, he added. There is a dark cloud hanging over our country right now. Meanwhile, star of the film Matt Damon and his wife Luciana Barroso looked incredible as they put on an affectionate display while attending the Suburb Icon screening at the Sala Grande on Saturday night. Luciana, 41, drew attention to her fabulous figure in an emerald green silk dress, while Matt, 46, looked dapper in a tuxedo. Luciana's Marquesa dress was cut asymmetrically to expose part of her décolletage, and featured a ruffle design at her midriff to draw attention to her tiny waist. She styled the dress with a pair of moss green tassel earrings, and worked her curly raven tresses into an updo. The Argentinian-born beauty drew attention to her eyes with bronze smoky eye makeup, and emphasized her stunning features with bronzer and frosted nude lipstick. The Born Identity star met Barroso, then working as a bartender, in April 2003 while filming Stuck on You in Miami. The couple have three daughters, Stella, 6, Gia, 8, and Isabella, who just turned 17 this month. Luciana also has an 18-year-old daughter from a previous marriage. Matt stars as Gardner Lodge in the film, who must navigate the town's dark underbelly of betrayal, deceit, and violence. Also at the red carpet premiere was Julianne Moore, who stars as Matt's on-screen wife and also his sister-in-law. The stunning flame-haired beauty, 56, turned heads in a Valentino 2017 gold dress, embellished with glitter-encrusted tassels. She teamed the plunging piece with a black body, wearing her hair in a sleek side parting as she showed off her natural beauty under minimal makeup. Speaking about the film's storyline recently, which tackles racial tensions, she said of today's society, "The only way they will do well is if the generation before them is doing that as well." Addressing the controversy surrounding the Civil War statues which kicked off the violence in Charlottesville, she added, "In the U.S., people are arguing about monuments. They must be removed. You simply cannot have these figures from the Civil War in town squares and universities for our children to see." America's divisions give an unnerving timeliness to Suburb Icon. The satirical film noir stars Matt Damon and Julianne Moore as residents of a seemingly idyllic, an all-white, 1950s suburban community that erupts in anger when a black family moves in. It fuses a script by the Coen brothers with a narrative about racial divisions inspired, in a negative way, by Donald Trump's presidential campaign. "I was watching a lot of speeches on the campaign trail about building fences and scapegoating minorities," Clooney said. That set Clooney and writing-producing partner Grant Haslove to thinking about other points in United States history when forces of division were in the ascendant. They remembered 1957 events in Levittown, Pennsylvania, a model suburban community where white residents rioted at the arrival of a black family. They fused that idea to an unproduced script by Joel and Ethan Coen about a similar white picket fence community where a crime goes horribly wrong. The images of white rage in the movie feel unnervingly contemporary, recalling last month's rallies in Charlottesville, Virginia. Unfortunately, these are issues that are never out of vogue in our country, Clooney said ahead of the film's red carpet premiere. We are still trying to exorcise these problems. We've still got a lot of work to do from our original sin of slavery and racism. I grew up in Kentucky and they would come to my hometown to do Civil War reenactments and they'd go to the townspeople and you got to pick if you wanted to be a Union or a rebel soldier. You wanted to be the rebel, it was fun. You didn't really understand the history of the Confederate flag. Now, if you want to wear it on your t-shirt or hang it off of your front lawn, have at it, good luck with your neighbors. But to hang it on a public building where, partially, African-American taxpayers are paying for it? That cannot stand and we have to come to terms with those things. On one level, Suburb Icon is a comedy, in which the best-laid plans of Damon's scheming corporate executive go bloodily astray. Damon and Moore practically explode with suburban repression, and there's a delicious turn by Oscar Isaac as a prying insurance investigator. Saturday was Damon's second time on the Venice red carpet this week. He also stars in Alexander Payne's Downsizing, in which, as so often, he portrays a likable everyman. But Damon also can play the psychopath, as he demonstrated memorably in The Talented Mr. Ripley. In Suburb Icon, he's a bland suburbanite who becomes a monster. I don't really get to play the bad guy a lot, but I do get a nice range of roles, Damon said. He recalled Payne telling him, I like you because you don't look like a movie star. And I know exactly what he meant, Damon said. I look kind of like an average American person, so I think directors get to have fun playing with different variations of what that might mean. For all the bloody fun in Suburb Icon, the social concerns Clooney displayed in previous films he directed, including Good Night, and Good Luck and The Ides of March, are never far from the surface. The Clooney Foundation he runs with his wife, human rights lawyer Amal Clooney, gave $1 million in the wake of Charlottesville to the Southern Poverty Law Center to combat hate groups. Clooney said he was anxious that Suburb Icon not be a polemic or a civics lesson. We wanted it to be funny, we wanted it to be mean, he said. But it is certainly angry, and it got angrier as we were shooting.